So we will first of all study what is introduction to vibration. I have taken this slide from SlideShare. This slide is being prepared by R. Narasimha Swami, senior consultant. So we will one by one see in the different slides. First of all, vibration is generally a phenomena, natural phenomena which occurs in daily to daily life. We always face that. If you take an example of simple pendulum, oscillates similarly in a musical instrument, it is used similarly when it is vehicle is traveling on a rough road, the vibration is going to occur. Similarly, during the buildings also, there is small amount of vibration which has to take place. In industries also, there are vibrations where it is going to occur. We see that it is going to occur in pumps, motors, fans and belts. So there is also vibration scope which is going to be occurring. So definitely you should know the definition of vibration. It is can be defined as simply the cyclic oscillating motion of a machine component from its position of rest. So we will see it one by one that vibration is basically naturally occurring also. That can take an example of rattling of tree leaves is also an example where the vibration is going to take. Similarly in the buildings, the earthquakes are the one of the form of vibrations. Similarly, unbalanced axle rotation and in also the flow induced. So when you see further, the basic concept of vibration is that the sources are characterized by their frequency domain properties. So categorized principally as means that it is a vibration is generally a periodic motion in which it is having a harmonic sinusoidal wave, and in some form vibration is also a randomly disturbance which we can say like the sound waves which are randomly coming. So that is also one form of a vibration waves. So what causes vibration? Let's say that any repeating force, like suppose this is a boat which is in the water, if there is one force acting from the other, the boat always tries to come to the mean position, and there is always an opposite inertia force which is going to act. So because of that it will try to oscillate. Similarly, in this bent shaft, when this shaft is bent, there will be the transferring of its CG. The CG will not be at the center of this body. So because of that, the centrifugal force will go up and down as the rotation is going to take place. And due to that, the shaft will try to oscillate. Similarly, here also you can see that there is an excessive wear, then this shaft will be unbalanced and this particular body will start vibrating. So here you can see that if this vibration are increased, the overall motor is going to increase, and this because of that, if the body is going to vibrate more, these bolts are going to loosen. So there is also one more thing, that is the resonance. The resonance generally occurs when we say that if any body is going to swing and if anyone is going to pushing that body, then ultimately because of that swing, the swing is going to be increased. So in the same manner, if its natural frequency is going to match with the external frequency, the body is going to have a resonance and there is a large amount of vibration which is going to create. So generally, we can summarize that what causes vibration. So change in direction with time. So if the load is changing with respect to time, then that is the vibration is going to occur. Similarly, change in amplitude. If the amplitude of load is continuously changing with time, such as and the magnetic field, or you can say that also creates a vibration. Similarly, friction is also one kind of a vibration creating element in a body which is having surface friction. It will have vibration because of this contact. Similarly, sudden impact may induce vibration like in your gears like that. Similarly, randomly generated turbulence force device such as fans, which is randomly going to generate, so that also is going to generate the vibrations. So one by one we will see some of the hazards of the vibrations, quality problems, severe machine damage, high power consumption, and because of that there is some maintenance causes, and because of that unnecessary cost is also going to add. So basically a model which is a mathematical model which we are going to study is a mass elastic system having natural frequency for few of lower order frequency. So generally a vibration is going to consist of number of equations, and these equations we have to study one by one. So these equations are going to prepared, and these are equations in the form of higher orders, so it will generally go with the vibration. Similarly, a system vibration in particular depicted the amplitude phase at various locations, so mode of vibrations can be also find out. So here you can see a basic model of a vibration, where you can see this is a mass, this is a spring, is denoted by k value stiffness, its distance initial, and when it is going to be pulled, it is going to have a certain deflection. So that deflection also you can see. So this is generally called as an undamped free vibration, where there is no damper present. So that is called as an undamped free vibration. Similarly, now you can see there is one damper also provided here. So this will become of mass, elastic mass, and a damping motion. And so generally, elastic or spring is an element which transfers the load from one element to another. It doesn't absorb any energy, but a damper is an element which absorbs the energy and dissipates the energy in the other form. So that's why it is one kind of element which takes the energy. And generally, if you draw the free body diagram of this particular thing, you will get this particular thing where your spring force you are going to apply on the mass MS, and here also on the mass MS. So this is generally a 2 degree of freedom system which we have shown here. So when you put here that equation of free body diagram according to Newton's second law, you will get this particular equation, and if you convert it into a matrix form, you will get this particular types of equation. So system characteristics, so if you see this particular spring mass damper system, here is the basic equation which we have got from the particular Newton's second law, and here is there is an external force Ft which is going to apply here. So basically that characteristic equation for free vibration is that there is no external force, it is vibrating on its own, then it will be called as a free vibration. And when if that equation you have to consider, then the amplitude of that is given by x is equal to x cos omega nt minus phi, where is phi is the your phase angle. So generally damped and undamped natural frequencies are shown here. This is one kind of your damped vibration, where that particular body is vibration is slowly it is going to diminish. And similarly here you can see it is one type of your damped vibration, but in general it is diminishing very quickly. So here you can see the curves. Here you can see this curve is your under damped vibrations. This is your critically damped vibration, which is going to position, is not going to reach to the mean position, it is slowly going to the path. And overdamped vibrations are this overdamped vibrations where it is overly damped, it is not yet reaching the mean position, but still there is a certain amount of energy which is stored inside. So generally the vibration can also be measured in terms of FFT analyzers. So FFT analyzers have certain kind of devices, like you can see here, this is an element, like this is a machine which is going to vibrate. There is certain accelerometer which you are going to place here. Accelerometer will transfer that signal, and when we are going to give an input, external input of any force which are going to apply, that's why that FT value you will get, and that response you will get in the output. So generally the FFT analyzer will measure the displacement of that curve, and it will also represent that vibration in terms of frequency domain also. So vibrations can be measured in displacement, velocity, acceleration. Acceleration is measured in terms of G, which is the force due to gravity, in that form also you can measure. So measurement chain involves that transducer. From transducer it will transfer that signal into an amplifier, where amplifier will again filter that signal according to what we are requiring, and it will again detector and average or whatever they have got, they will analyze here and then will give the output. So again you can see this cycle here, where again same thing is going on, and we will see that end result in the output. So here one again example, you can see that if this is an arrangement, if this is a machine where there are two gears engaging, and if there is a vibration created, then there you can see that they have put one sensor here. This sensor is going to give the amplitude versus displacement time, or amplitude versus time, and this is the vibrations which are being created. And when you plot same thing on the amplitude versus frequency domain, you will get such kind of thing. So C, D, A, B, C, D, will represent the vibrations or amplitude at which the more vibrations are there. So you can see at E there is more vibration, so that it will tell you that that is the place which is the critical point. So generally this kind of curves will get in terms of acceleration. When you are measuring, it will be like this. When in terms of velocity you are measuring, you will get like this. So again this curves you can see. So here also you can see an example of a fan where you are measuring the vibration of the fan. So again along the frequency domain, the vibrations you are measuring here. So this graph shows you that how the vibrations are going to vary. So then again G value, it is nothing but the mass acceleration due to gravity, and its value is 9.81 Newton. So basically what is the force which are we going to face when a passenger car in corner, it gets 2G, bumps in the road 2G. So in this way you can just get an example that when you are in a space shuttle you will get a 10G force. So that is what I want to tell you, and that's at the end of my slide. So I hope you like it and enjoy that particular slide, and you will enjoy the vibration.